Backstage was very magical. Initially, it had the air of a Gaelic talk about it, where you're just with your friends, you've no parents, and you can do what you want. That kind of sense of freedom. That's the way the bands always kind of are.
To be honest with you, Backstage wasn't really any more respectable looking than the front of the stage. It was pretty much the same sort of behaviour that was going on, whether you were with the band or whether you were part of the audience.
All the dressing rooms were port cabins, and I think there was even tents back there. It was very casual by modern standards. You could drive in very easily. Passes were, it was a new idea, the idea of having a wristband or the right pass to get to the right place. And it was nice for that. They had an informality that was, you don't get nowadays.
They had these massive kegs full of booze and ice, you know. So if anybody got sort of particularly, inebriated, they would just stick their head in the actual keg.
I'm sure people in Thurles will remember what the town was like, and there were people asleep on top of bus stops. There was the full nine yards was going on around the stadium. I think probably in the stadium as well.
People around Thurles were like kind of taken in families. It was almost like the evacuation in World War II, or like some sort of mad refugee type situation. And there were like, you know, like families taking other families into a home, camping their backyard. And it was just a great community event.
A lot of workers in town at the time would have got very little sleep, because the failure was something new, like, and they worked around the clock, you know, and I'm sure publicans and ambulance service and Gardaí and everyone, you know, in general, worked around the clock and were delighted to work around the clock and made a few pounds out of them.
I was only 15, so I was still, well, it was summer holidays, but I was still in school. But I'm lucky I was here at all, Mary, because I nearly was a Hare Krishna.
For all the madness at the gigs and in the campsite and in the square, there was this real kind of sense of togetherness as well, which was really special.
We had a shop across the road, because we live across the road from the stadium, and me, my mother and her two friends were working, and there was so much money to take. We were literally catching the bundles of money and putting it into plastic bags and maybe a couple into our back pockets, putting into the bag and throwing in under stairs. Mm. We couldn't, Mammy was doing microwave burgers for euro or pound back then, yeah. And sure, we couldn't store, like, I mean, hopping.
Oh, everybody had a bed and breakfast set up in their house, and there's loads of little extra restaurants and things. So it went on day and night. People were just looking for food the whole time, weren't they?
Yeah. You never saw kind of different religions. And, you know, you were a small town, and these men all dressed in orange and, you know, all hats and, you know, all coming over, you know. But
all happy.
Yeah, but they were all happy.
We came out at lunchtime and the Hare Krishnas were dancing around.
Was that dear?
I saw the man falling off the roof over there, off the stand there at that time. I don't know if you hear that story, but I actually saw that. I was out in the middle of the field and I got a fright.
I remember well being here one day when the fella climbed up on top of the roof of the stadium and he decided to play bagpipes.
Some guy climbed up a stand there and fell off while World Party was on it one year. Yeah, don't think he was too well after that.
There was this guy up on the roof, and he decided to fall off the roof, and, you know, a whole shock went through the whole stadium. And he was fine.
He survived. I don't know how he did, but he was definitely sore the next morning when he woke up. Anyway.
On the first Feile, I remember it seemed like the whole Irish music business descended. Dave Fanning was there, Paul Brennan at a Clannad was there, even though Clannad weren't playing. The Edge was there, even though I'm pretty sure you two weren't playing.
We were playing football here at about, say, 6 o'clock in the morning. At Feile.
Yeah? Were we?
I think it was the first Feile, and we had played it, and we were so excited, we stayed up all night. And we knew all of the crew. Do you remember, it was all those Galway lads that used to work with Mockness and stuff, and they were all still up. And a lot of them were off duty because they...
And we were camping backstage. We camped backstage about 2 or 3 years in a row.
Yeah, we did, yeah. So we were camping back there, and a lot of the crew were off duty, and we all ended up here playing like five-a-side football. And there was crew working on stage, getting the stage ready for the next day. and we were wrecking their heads because we were using the stage as the goal. And we were taking shots and penos up, and there was the ball was hopping off
the ball up on the stage.
It was hopping off flight cases and all this kind of stuff. And
I have no recollection.
You don't remember
that? Not at all.
I think that was definitely the first failure.
Yeah.